On today's episode of Identity, fitness and wellness solutions provider Dumi Pake hangs out in the Identity coffee shop. We experience the beauty of isiXhosa culture in Vosloorus, Johannesburg. What's Happening features the review of a healthy seafood recipes app and an inspirational website. And we play out with a song by Berita Mwana wa Mai.
An individual with an imagination. My inner faith illuminates innovations. In a space with infinite inspiration. I was born free from all incarceration. Incredible, living infallibly. Intelligent, outshine with my inner being. This is me, impeccable as ever been. I am you, you are me.
This is my identity.
Kodani mabukeli basemzansi. Siyabulela kakhulu ngokubukela iIdentity khona pha ku-SABC 1 Mzansi for sure. Ngumsasazi wenu uBiwe Gcwala. Here on Identity, we're all for empowering and bringing you, our valued viewers, informative entertainment that makes a positive impact in your lives. Today's guest, Insert and Reviews aim to do just that. So sit back and enjoy what we have in store for you. First order of business, let's check out today's inspirational hashtag throwback interview. Today we feature an insightful chat I had with founder of Zenzele Fitness Group, Dumi Pake. Take a look. The gentleman joining me today can be best described as a fitness maverick. Itumeleng Pake is a health and fitness enthusiast with a passion for changing the corporate approach to health. After 7 years in the corporate banking field, Dumi quit his job to pursue his entrepreneurship dream. Today is the CEO of the Zenzele Fitness Group, a company that provides wellness and fitness solutions to corporate and government clients. With fitness playing such a huge role in modern day society, I had to invite him for a chat. Dumi, welcome to Identity.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, I want to find out about your childhood.
My childhood, it was quite a diverse childhood. I was brought up by my grandparents, actually, and you know, I lived in a big household. There was probably about 13 of us. You know, my grandmother was an entrepreneur, and she took care of all of us. So I had my aunts, my cousins. And it was a very big sort of dynamic family, and yeah, it was great. So, you know, I was born in Soweto. I played rugby, basketball, and sport was always something that I really aspired to do. And you know, funny enough, when I finished high school, I started working for a bookstore, and I got interested in reading books, and I was really drawn into reading financial books and accounting and that. And I thought, maybe that's what I'd like to do.
I just want to find out about your spirituality. How important is spirituality to you?
Spirituality is actually, it's always been something that, you know, that I had. I mean, I'm a, you know, when people ask me, do you belong in any religion? I tell them, no, I'm a spiritual person. Mm-hmm. You know, and I think reading was probably one of the biggest drivers. It opened my eyes in terms of the approach to spirituality that, you know, it's not... it's diverse, it's open, you can express it in your own way, you can drive it your own way, you can speak to God in your own language, you know what I'm saying? There's no rules on how you should do it. And also, I mean, I think my mother is a very, you know, spiritual person, and she also sort of helped me with my spiritual journey.
So what solidified you getting into the banking industry sector? Because I know you touched upon it and said that it was attributed to you reading so much, but what actually solidified you to actually take a career in investment banking?
I don't think at the point I necessarily knew what I wanted to do, but I just thought that it's safe, it's secured. You know, having, you know, a finance degree on your background is actually a good thing. Mm-hmm. But little did I know that, you know, there's like a next journey that I'm, and that's what I think secured it. I think I just always knew that whatever business that you'll run, mm-hmm. you always need a solid financial background. Yeah. And I thought either way, you know, by default, you know, whether I sell books, I still need to understand how to run yeah. the business. Yeah. So that will always come into play. And yeah, so I think it was always going to be a win-win situation.
But you took a leap of faith and you quit your job and went into your passion, which is fitness and health. That must have been challenging. What brought about that change?
It was challenging. I mean, some people thought I was crazy. And the funny thing is, at the time where I was trying to obviously retire from, you know, working for someone, things started happening at work, you know, getting promotions and doing that. And I remember telling my mother, like, maybe I should just stick around. And, you know, at that time, I actually obtained a capital injection in the business. And my mother was like, put your resignation letter already, like, do this.
Yeah.
You know, she played a very, like, you know, she was really cheerleading me all the way. And I think having someone in your life that sort of believes in you more than you believe in yourself is very important.
So I see you wearing your Zenzele Fitness cap.
I had to. I'm sorry, I had to.
Tell us about it. What does it entail? What is it about exactly?
You know, Zenzele, I mean, you know, my journey, I think, you know, there's obviously some frustration in the corporate world. I think, you know, there's politics, growth in the corporate world, and just, I suppose it was also like an internal thing where I wanted to grow.